in 1993, I was working in Denver, Colorado for a law firm called Home Roberts & Owen, and at the time I wasn't working under Kevin Mitnick, I was working under the name of Eric Weiss. Why not Kevin Mitnick? Because certain federal authorities wanted to talk to me and I didn't want to have a conversation with them. In fact, I didn't want them to know where I was. And the reason I chose the name Eric Weiss is because that's the real name of Harry Houdini, my favorite magician. I thought I had a sense of humor, but I learned later the FBI did not. None at all. So my colleague handed me this brochure for the MicroTac Ultralight, and which is this device. It's like the flip phone of the 1990s. It's like the iPhone of today. People love this phone. And as a hacker, I wanted to understand how it worked. I wanted to know the protocols, how cellular phone technology worked, because I was passionate with telephony for my phone freaking years. So I made a very stupid and regrettable decision to go after the source code of Motorola's MicroTac. So one early afternoon, I left the law office. I got down to the bottom floor of the cash register building in Denver, and I called directory assistance for toll-free numbers. I simply asked for Motorola. Got the number to a Motorola, talked to a receptionist. I said, "Hi, I'm looking for the project manager of the MicroTac, Ultralight." And the nice receptionist said, "All our cellular phone developments handled out of Schaumburg, Illinois. Would you like that number?" "Certainly," she gave me the number. I called Schaumburg, got a different receptionist. I said, "Hey, I'm looking for the project manager of the MicroTac Ultralight." And I was transferred around 2, 3, 5 by the 8th call. I'm talking to the vice president of all of Motorola Mobility. And I said, "Hey, I'm looking for the project manager of the MicroTac Ultralight." This is Rick over in Arlington Heights, because during my previous calls, one person asked me if I'm from Arlington Heights. So I just included it to build trust and credibility. And he said, "Yes, that's Pam. She works for me. Would you like her extension?" I said, "Please." Gave me the extension. He goes, "Can I help you?" I go, no, that's okay. Because I don't want to ask a VP what I wanted to ask Pam. So I call Pam, and I didn't get her. I got her outgoing greeting that she left on her voicemail. And she told callers that she just left on a 2-week vacation, the date she's returning, and if you need any help whatsoever, please call Alicia on extension, blah, blah, blah. Who's my next call to? And this is by the time I'm walking in a snowstorm in downtown Denver, my apartment's 15 minutes away, and what I'm literally doing is I'm pressing the phone so hard to my ear so you can't hear traffic noise, because I'm never expecting this to work. It's all extemporaneous. No plan, no reconnaissance. I just figured, hey, it might be a cool thing to do on the walk home, right? So I call Alicia. I go, "Hi, Alicia. This is Rick over in Arlington Heights, R&D. How are you doing?" She goes, "Fine." We exchange pleasantries. I go, "Did Pam leave on vacation yet?" "Oh, she has. Well, she told me before she left she was going to give me the copy of the latest release for the MicroTac Ultralight, the source code. But she said if she didn't have a chance, I could always call you because you'll help me out." And then I wasn't expecting her response. And her response was, "What version do you want?" I didn't even look up the version etiquette. And I was thinking as I was walking, and I go, "How about the latest and the greatest?" So she started typing on her computer for about 5, 6, 7, 8 minutes. And she goes, "Rick, I found the latest release of the MicroTac, but there's a problem." I go, "What's the problem?" She goes, "There's hundreds of directories in each file, and there's hundreds of files in each directory." Then I said, "Alicia, do you know how to use char and gzip? And she goes, "No." And I go, "That's like WinZip under Windows." And I said, "Would you like to learn? I could teach you." And she said, "Yes." So I became her instructor, and I taught her how to use tar and gzip. And at the end of the lesson, we had a 3-megabyte file of the source code I wanted to look at. My next question to Alicia is, "Do you know how to use FTP? And she goes, "File transfer program." I go, "Precisely." And again, off the cuff, extemporaneous, no preparation. I couldn't give her a host name of hacker.colorado.edu. So I had a good knack for remembering numbers, so I gave her an IP address of a system where she could log in with like anonymous FTP and upload files. So she tried to make a connection to this IP address, and it failed, and she tried a couple more times, and the connection timed out, and she goes, "Rick." I go, "Yes." She goes, I'm going to talk to my security manager about what you're asking me to do. I'll be right back. I go, no, wait. And I was on hold. I figured, this is not going to work in 5 minutes from my house, and I might as well just hit end on the cell phone and say, oh, I tried. But I said, what the heck? Might as well stay on and see what happens. But I got a little bit nervous because she was taking so long. I thought they were going to hook up a tape recorder, and that was going to be Exhibit A for a later court case. So when she came back on the line, and she goes, Rick? Uh-huh. She goes, that IP address you gave us is outside of Motorola's campus. Uh-huh. And, you know, notice I'm not saying words. And she goes, my security manager told me that we cannot send files to outside IP addresses unless we use a special proxy server, and I don't have an account to send you the file. And I go, uh-huh, I was very disappointed. But she goes, you know what, I have great news for you. I go, what? She goes, my security manager gave me his personal username and password so I could upload the file. So by the time I put the key into the front door of my apartment, I have the latest and greatest source code to the MikroTik Ultralight. So I think this really illustrates the threat and impact of social engineering extemporaneously. A good gift of gab and just following your instincts leads to the crown jewels of a major company.